Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest Let's Play of Train Simulator 2022. And today, folks, we're going to be doing something a wee bit different, as we are going to be using quick drive mode, and the train we are using will be this Class 700. So I'm just going to release the doors, just to let passengers board and stuff. And we'll just set up the lights as well. Also picked this one up in a Steam sale as well. So, as you know, I never pay full price for any of the add-ons. Always take advantage and wait for the sales. I'm just panning the camera back round. And I just want to show you the train from external view. As you can see in the cab, there isn't really anything to... much to it, to be honest with you, as most of the console is hidden. But if we just pan it around, you can see the controls here and there, but from the default view, this is kind of what you get. So I'm just going to tilt this slightly down just so that we can see the console a bit better, and I'll just get that into as close to the original position as we can. Anyway, folks, I'm going to do a thumbnail image with this train on the move, and I'm just doing a demonstration run from Brighton to Gatwick Airport, so it's not going to be too much of a very long journey, to be honest with you folks. I'm not sure how accurate this train is, but I think I may need to use the master key or something, but nonetheless, I'm just going to put the brake on and we'll set up the train and then get going. Oh, just a question, by the way, folks. As I've never been on a real Class 700, how accurate are these sounds? I'm just curious, because to me, that sounds very much like a Class 350 and a Class 450. And my question is, are these sounds accurate? As I thought, this sound should be louder and more high-pitched. Just curious. But anyway, folks, we do have a Class 465. That's just random generated by the train simulator in itself. As you know, I do not have the route to use the included scenarios with, but I'm just wondering why this sounds like a Class 350. Just sounds odd, that's all. Anyways, this is just going to be a direct express to Gatwick Airport, just to give you a taste of what this add-on is all about. And if we just go into view number 5, this one is of course is in the cabin. Let's see if we can move around. Sadly not. So you can't use the left and arrow keys either. And there is no view of left and right cameras to move around the cab either. So to be honest, I'm not too impressed with this add-on, and I certainly would not pay the full £12 asking price for this. So I'd say this would definitely need an enhancement pack or something, just to make it a bit more convincing. So when Armstrong Powerhouse does an enhancement pack for this, if there's not one already released, then I'll definitely will be getting that one. I'm going to increase my power, folks, just to bring us up to 75 miles an hour. But I can understand the negative reviews on Steam for this add-on, as to be honest. I was expecting to move the camera around the cab, just like with most of the other add-ons that I have. So, a bit disappointing then, in my opinion. Other than that, if you have to get this add-on, I would recommend just getting it in the Steam sales. Anyways, let's crank this up to 100, folks. Let's just see what the physics are like then, shall we? It does have a working alerter, but Class 350 sounds. I'm not sure, and I'm very doubtful that they even are suitable for this train. Anyways, just taking the power off there, just to avoid breaking the speed limit, okay? It does cruise nice, though. So, that's kind of what it has going for it, really. But the sounds, and the limited manoeuvrability in the cab, other than where you have to use the mouse just to move, just to look around, instead of using the arrow keys, which would have been a nice option, in my opinion. There's not really much to it, to be honest. But I will get an enhancement pack for this, and hopefully that will fix a lot of the problems. Anyways, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to let you sit back and enjoy the driver's eye view of the tracks, okay? And I'll talk to you a bit more once we reach Gatwick. That's, to be honest with you, folks, there's really nothing much to mention about this add-on. I'm not too impressed with the quality, to be honest. It could be a lot better. The 3D model's grand. It looks really great. But the sounds and the cameras that I've previously mentioned, that could have been a lot better. Thank you. I nearly forgot to do that, folks, so I'm just glad I remembered to do the thumbnail. And that's the alert going off, or the vigilance alarm. So I'll just reset that with the QK. I do have another critic about this train, and I don't like how lightweight the power handle is, as it's quite easy to go from power to brake as well. I should think there should be more of a solid neutral in the off position, so that when you go from power to idle, it should be more resistance rather than just throwing it into brake. That's just my opinion. Anyways, we are about 10.5 miles to go before we reach Gatwick. I did mention that this one would just be a quick run, and there's not been too much NPC traffic about either, so I'm not sure why the route is poison. I may have to do another clear cache, as I've been doing quite a lot of Let's Play videos today, to be honest with you folks. Or at least at the time this one was recorded anyways. Likewise, just going to idle the power again, folks. And it will drop down naturally. But this train could have been better. In my utmost honest opinion, this add-on could have been better. I'm not saying it's bad, but I do agree with the negative reviews on Steam, unfortunately. And to be honest with you, I do hope that there will be an enhancement pack for this, and I'm looking forward to getting that, along with a Class 60 enhancement pack. So hopefully this year of 2022 will be mostly train simulator Let's Plays and railway related Let's Plays. As you know, I did mention in one of the other videos, I think it could have been this one, that I class the year of the Tiger of 2022 as the year of the train, hence why I've been doing more train simulation stuff instead of other video games and stuff, you know. Anyways, I'm just going to increase that power back up again, just to keep our speed as close to 90 miles an hour as we can. And we're not too far away now from Gatwick, folks. So, it's been quite a nice run. Shame about the letdown and the lack of features I was hoping that this train would have. But it is modern, and it does fill the gap. And I assume that Dovetail Games will do some of the modern diesel and electric multiple units, like the Class 196 and all those kind of trains. To be honest with you folks, I'm not really up on the UK new trains, as I tend to focus more of my interest on the British Rail stuff. So I'm more in line with that than I am on this new stuff. So when those add-ons do come out, please pardon my ignorance in advance, okay? As I will get them, and I do have another Let's Play to come. Just cancel that vigilance there, so we don't get a brake application. And we are coming up to an 80 miles an hour zone as well. So we're not too far away now from Gatwick. We're about just under 6.5 miles to go, and that will be where this Let's Play will finish, as this is a quick drive and not a full-fledged scenario. Have you noticed something else about the horn as well? When you sound the low tone, that does loop. But when you do the high tone, it's just non-looped. So that does limit the horn signal sequence, in my opinion. So if you were to do a long tone, for example, when passing a signal at danger with authorization from the signaller, it does limit the ability to do realistic combinations with a two-tone horn. So although the low tone is okay, that does loop, the high tone does not. Okay folks, we're not too far away now from Gatwick Airport, and I do apologise for the lack of NPC trains driving about, as to be honest, this is just computer generated. So that's one of the pitfalls of the quick drive mode, as where if I've made a scenario for it, I would have added more NPC traffic trains just to make the experience more enjoyable. However, we're just coming into Gatwick, folks, so I'm just going to start using a wee bit of braking just to bring our speed down. And that, my friends, will be the end of this Let's Play. And this is just to give you an idea of what to expect from this modern add-on from Dovetail Games. It is a nice train. I do like the 3D modelling. It's really, really nice, in my opinion. The 3D modelling and the texturing looks great too. But, and the handling to a point, that's also good as well. But the lack of camera views in both the driving cab and the train itself, it is a bit limiting, really. And I'm not even sure if this train has opening windows or not, but I will cover this add-on again once I get the enhancement pack. In fact, what I can do, as we're slowing down, I'll just see if we can open the cab window, and we can, so that's grand. So we do have opening cab windows, and the cab is very high quality textures as well. The texturing is reasonable, and I've got this one setting below maximum, and it's not too bad, but it's definitely not HD texturing. But the real pitfalls of this add-on, in my utmost opinion, folks, it has to be the Class 350 and 450 Desiro sounds, as I'm fairly sure actually that this train does not sound like a Class 350 or a Class 450 in the real world, and the traction motors do have a much higher pitch sound from what I've heard of them on YouTube. But anyway, folks, that, my friends, is the end of this Let's Play. And a big thank you for watching if you watched all the way through. Until next time, folks, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, and I'll catch you in the next one.